At the 21st consecutive Sport Hunting Games, Pablo Jr. won his 10th championship, setting a new dog record in the Locate the Squirrel event in a whopping 10.53 seconds. He has now equaled his father, Pablo Sr., for the most championships won at a professional level. But have you ever wondered what makes Pablo Jr. predisposed to such great sporting success, especially when compared to our second place getter, Mademoiselle the Poodle, who would much prefer to entertain the crowd, and our third place getter, Cookie the Magician? Welcome to the genetic basis of stuff and things. Pablo Jr. spends at least 4 hours a day training at the kennels, working on the skills required to make an exemplary sport hunting dog. He locates and pretends squirrels and works on his agility skills by flying over hurdles and sprinting through tunnels. However, so does Mademoiselle and Cookie, with little to no success. The three of them are also fed similar diets, utilize the same training methods, and are most importantly surrounded by endless love. So now that we've established that food, training, and a little bit of extra love are not factors that determine sporting success, whatever else could it be? Well, maybe the answer isn't anything to do with external factors, but something that occurs at a level that cannot be seen to the human eye, hidden in the realm of genetics. After all, Pablo Jr.'s dad, Pablo Sr., was also a renowned champion. Extensive studies in humans have found that genetic makeup contributes substantially to the remarkable success of athletes. However, Kim and his team wanted to investigate the historical forces and selection targets that have impacted this genetic makeup. To do so, they utilized the very first domesticated species, the modern dog, as a model organism that would better enable them to understand the selective pressures associated with human athleticism. These minds utilized the whole genome sequencing of three groups of dogs, sport hunting, terrier, and village, to identify regions that were under strong selection, meaning they looked for regions that seemed to be affected by strong selective pressures. A total of 59 genes were found to have a strong selective sweep in sport hunting dogs, resulting in allele frequencies that were highly differentiated between the three populations. Basically, this meant that certain alleles which occurred at a greater frequency in the sport hunting group were not so common and occurred at a lower frequency in the non-sport hunting groups. This was suggestive of strong selective pressures affecting the sport hunting group compared to the terrier and village non-sport hunting groups. Elite athletic performance is known to be a complex interaction between factors enhancing muscular, cardiovascular, and neurological functions. According to the online Mendelian Inheritance in Man and UniProt databases, 11 of the 59 genes found to have a strong selective sweep were related to these three functions. Four of those 11 genes were related to fatigue-enhanced muscle pain, vascular smooth muscle contraction, heart rate, and hypertension. Other genes also included those that are crucial for synapse formation and neuronal migration, emphasizing the complex array of factors that enhance sporting performance. Let's take a closer look at some positively selected genes and the associated alleles that occurred at a significantly higher frequency in the sport hunting group. The RoBo1 gene was found to have an incredibly strong association with agility in sport hunting dogs. Dogs with the A allele at a certain position within the RoBo1 gene were more likely to win titles in agility than dogs with a lower frequency of this specific allele. The T allele, at a certain position in the ASIC3 gene, was found to be more common in the sport hunting group compared to the non-sport hunting groups. It is hypothesized that this specific allele increased in frequency due to its loss of function effect, helping to prevent pain after exercise. So basically, Kim and his team established that dogs like Pablo Jr. and his father are predisposed to athletic success by having a certain variant of a gene, the golden allele. However, they also alluded to the strong selective pressures experienced by the sport hunting group. What exactly do they mean? Well, you see, more than 14,000 years of artificial selection, inbreeding, and population bottlenecks have created dog breeds with superior strength, agility, and hunting prowess. Breed dogs have developed from two major bottlenecks. The first bottleneck occurred more than 15,000 years ago and was the domestication of the ancestral grey wolf, also known as the Canis lupus, into the early dog. The second bottleneck during the Victorian era was associated with modern breed formation and included intense artificial selection and inbreeding as humans carefully selected traits to fulfill a certain purpose. Artificial selection can be seen in the formation of sport hunting breeds like Pablo Jr., who originates from a long line of Hungarian Whistlers bred for their swift and cautious hunting abilities. Homozygosity for some dog breeds across significant parts of their genome is suggestive of mating across close relatives, otherwise known as inbreeding. This played an integral role in creating an artificial bottleneck, reducing the gene pool and creating breeds with the lower levels of heterozygosity compared to their wolf ancestors. However, it was paramount in creating dogs with desired traits, such as their superior hunting and retrieving abilities that are highly prevalent in sport hunting dogs. While inbreeding may no longer occur, further artificial bottlenecks include the population sire effect, which decreased the gene pool even further. So this resulted in breeds with incredibly refined genomes, as seen in the variants of genes that occurred at a significantly higher frequency in the sport hunting group. Does this mean we could create more champion dogs like Pablo Jr.? Yes, but it is a double-edged sword. The domestication of the modern dog came with severe ramifications as it heavily impacted levels of deleterious mutations. Breed dogs with a past associated with inbreeding have an increased probability of being homozygous for a lethal recessive variant. Deleterious variants at nearby loci can also increase in frequency due to hitchhiking surrounding sweep regions. For an example, selection for the black coat color in poodles like Mademoiselle caused a higher frequency of variants of the KITLG gene. This resulted in increased instances of squamous cell carcinoma in the digit. However, it is paramount to understand that even the most talented and genetically gifted dog will succumb to two things: belly rubs and a squeaky orange ball.